Hello and a very warm welcome to you. I'm Hayley Palmer. It's so good to have you on tonight's show, especially as we are joined by the winners of Little Mix, The Search. Yes, since September are here with us on tonight's show. And here is what happened when I caught up with Harry and Patrick. Guys, it's great to have you on the show. How are you doing?
Hello, yeah, great, hello. Thank you. How are you?
Yeah, I'm really good. I hate to say it, but I'm too hot. Am I allowed to say that?
Yeah, I think you can.
Yeah, I think we're going to say it as well. You're going to see me sweating a lot.
So it's sticky.
It's bad. It's bad.
We're professionals, guys. We can do this, you know.
Thank it's absolutely you, thank fine. You so much for having us on,
I really wanted to get you guys on the show because, Harry, I met you at London in the Sky. Amazing experience, wasn't it?
Oh, it was amazing, yeah. It's a good thing for both of us that you met me an hour earlier than what could have been, because we probably wouldn't have had this meeting set up.
Amazing. So big shout out to Will from Capital who introduced me to you guys. And I've got to say, the donuts were amazing. Did you have any?
Yeah, absolutely.
Ridiculous. I could only get like two bites into mine because it was just so sweet. I had the Biscoff one and it was just really like, it was so bad. It was amazing though. I'm actually gutted I couldn't have the whole thing. It tasted so good. It was like too good. So good that I couldn't have it.
Too good. I had two back-to-back.
The only problem with London in the Sky is that you're in the air 45 minutes drinking the whole time. There's no toilets up there. That was the problem.
Do you know what, Harry? You gave me that good advice before I went up there. You said, make sure you go to the toilet, and I did. So I do thank you for that. Anyway, we're going to move on from that and talk about you guys. I mean, you were the winners of the BBC Little Mix, The Search. Well, your prize is to support Little Mix on their 2022 tour. Harry, let's come to you first of all. Tell us about your experience from the beginning.
The Little Mix experience was like ridiculous because I did it on just a whim. You know, I was an estate agent. Whoa. At the time. I was God. Pretty much given up on the music thing. I was like, I've been doing it for way too long and I wasn't getting anywhere. And that opportunity came out of nowhere. And just from the offset, it was just better than any experience that I've had before with those types of shows, you know, like this one and, you know, those types of shows. So it was just honestly from the very beginning to the very end, it was unbelievable. And the girls are lovely as well.
Oh, yeah, I bet they were. And Patrick, coming to you, because you're a student as well, so your life must have really changed.
Yeah, well, I managed to, you know, leave uni. I actually need to fill out my form to leave uni today, officially.
Make sure you do.
So, yeah, absolutely ridiculous how my life has changed in the last year. The thing that, like, really resonates with me is the fact that I now, like, wake up every day and I just want to, like, work really, really hard at something that I love
so
much.
Your passion.
Yeah, exactly. And it's like I was working, you know, all the way through school, sixth form, went to uni and everything. I was working. I was good at what I was working at, but it wasn't like I didn't have that drive and that gusto for it. And, I'm very lucky that the Little Mix experience came around because it's allowed me to, you know, completely change my life. It's great.
Yeah, no, I totally agree with that because I went through years of working in an office and I just felt really rubbish. I couldn't be bothered to get up. But you're right, when it's your passion, you know, you've got goals you want to achieve. And it's the hard work that goes on behind the scenes, right? Because obviously we see you winning the competition. But I mean, you guys must be so busy just songwriting and, you know, using this time effectively, right?
100%, yeah. It does still feel like we've got full-time jobs. It's just a job that we absolutely enjoy, you know.
Yes.
We completely love it. There's just so much to do nowadays. It's like, I'm sure, you know, even 5 years ago there wasn't TikTok, and you know, 15 years ago there wasn't YouTube, and now everyone has to be on all of those. So
It's important.
You're spending a lot of your time you know, doing the Renegade and stupid dances and stuff.
We love your stupid dances, but anyway, we're gonna play out on the show your cover of Amy Winehouse, Back to Black. This is so good. Harry, who came up with the arrangement for this?
I think it was something we just smashed our heads together on when we were doing the Empty Seats tour, which I think we'll talk about later, but we just wanted to, it was the first time we've been together in months and months and months, and we're like, oh, should we just jam through a cover? And that one just kind of naturally came to be, you know. We knew we had to keep it short in case it got used on the show. So I think we just kind of mashed our heads together. It's the way it works with most things in this group.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, we're going to check it out right now. You're going to love this at home, and we will see you after this.
He left no time to regret.
kept his lips wet with his same old safe bet. Me and my head held high, let my tears dry, gets on without my guide. You went back to what you do, so far removed from all that we went through. Sigh, I let a trouble try, and my heart are stuck, and I'll go back to blood. We can only say goodbye with words. I died 100 times, yeah. And you go back to her, then I go back to you. We only say goodbye with words, and I died 100 times, oh yeah. You go back to her, then I'll go back to you. Oh, and I love you, but that's not enough. I love blow and you love pour. And love feels like a pipe that I'm a tiny
you. If it's not you, it's not anyone.
talk about your tour with Little Mix. Can you give us any goss, Patrick? What have you got planned?
What haven't we got planned? We're literally playing every arena in the UK. Like, that is, it's just the most mental thought. I forget about it sometimes, and it just crosses my mind, like, oh, we're playing to over 500,000 people in a month. Like, you know, wow. What's going on there? And, I mean, we may be taking someone with us to video the experience, get a bit of content there, yeah. So we'll have that, like, long-lasting video memory for the bits that we might not remember. But yeah, like, I'm just so ready to, like, get out on the road and actually do it proper. Like, you know, last time I did a tour, I was, like, 18 in our mate's dad's van. Like, banged up in the back of it with all our guitars, like, on top of us, driving 7 hours to the next festival. So now I get to do it properly, like, playing the O2. I'm so excited.
Yeah, tell us about the Empty Seats tour, because this has been a three-part series, hasn't it? Yeah. How did this all come about?
So, the kind of behind the cameras, behind the scenes at Little Mix The Search was, you know, as enjoyable as on screen. So, like, all the people we worked with, Andrea at Modest TV, she was unbelievable. And she really kind of believed in us from the start, and you could kind of see that. And then even afterwards, after the show, she called us up and she said, look, there's an opportunity here for you guys to go on, you know, an Empty Seats tour, and we can document it for YouTube or whatever.
Great.
So, yeah, so we ended up doing that. And it was just, it was amazing, to be honest with you. It was so much fun. And it was so good to see, because we hadn't seen, Matt had been living with me for a month or so in Coventry, but we hadn't seen the rest of the boys since the show, or since Blue Peter. So it was unreal. It was so good.
But you guys all live together now, right?
Mm-hmm. We live together now, yeah. I mean, I'm basically the cleaner.
I'm the one that makes the mess.
Yeah.
Okay, that works quite well then. Match made in heaven.
Yeah, exactly. We've all got jobs, so it's not my fault that he's the cleaner.
Yes, keep that up. Well done.
Yeah, man. I just throw things around and just be like, hi.
That's not a job. You treat it like a job.
Oh, I'm sure you guys are brilliant and it works really well, and massive success coming your way.
I'll tell you what, though. Harry makes a mean curry. Harry makes
the meanest
curry.
Oh, really? So you've all got your little pitch and it so works. Nice. I like it.
Yeah, it's all real.
I'm big time the maid here.
He's his dad, like, he's his father Harry.
I enjoy it.
Oh, do you? Well, yeah, I've got to say, I'm absolutely rubbish at housework, so yeah, I wouldn't be good at living with a group of people. We're going to go into, Harry, your song choice. Rascal Flatts, Life is a Highway. Why this song?
I mean, he'll tell you, there's always country music playing out of my bedroom, you know, blasting out. But this song just reminds me, particularly this time of year, it's so sunny. And with my mates, and it just takes you back to being on the road on the Empty Seats tour. And what's to come, you know? Life is a highway.
Yeah, and what's it like when you go on tour? Are you quite good at travelling? Because I get really bad travel sickness.
I'm really bad. I'm the worst. So I always have to sit in the front. The front always.
Yeah, that's what I'm like. Yeah, I've got to be able to see out okay.
Yeah, but I get really bad travel sickness. Like, there's pictures of me asleep. Yeah. On the floor in the tour bus and stuff. It's
Harry's up front making small talk with the driver while we're in the back snoozing.
Brilliant stuff. We're going to play out the song, and we look forward to seeing you in just a couple of minutes' time. All right, now guys, we have got a quick fire question round for you, because we want to know you a little bit better. Are you ready? I know it's hot.
Yeah, let's do this.
I'm fried. Let's give it a go.
Okay, Harry. If you could have only one app on your phone, what would it be?
Instagram.
Yeah, it's got to be, hasn't it?
Yeah.
Patrick, what was the last thing you Googled?
Can I check? Am I allowed to check? There's a guy called Aaron Fraser. He's the drummer in a band called Jaron Jones and the Indications.
Okay.
I wanted to figure out how old he was, because I really couldn't tell, but I can't even check, but I'll
take your word for it. Like it. Harry, last meal on earth, what would it be?
Oh, it'd have to be a really dirty mac and cheese with all kinds of cheese.
Well, that sounds incredible. Patrick, karaoke song.
Oh, Superstition by Stevie Wonder.
Oh, yes, tune. Yeah. Harry, best thing on the Nando's menu. This is very important. Answer wisely.
Oh, I don't know. Back to cheese. The halloumi.
Incredible. Patrick, what's your favourite word?
Conglomerate.
Sorry, what?
Conglomerate. It's like...
Okay.
Yeah, just... It rolls off the tongue nicely.
Amazing. Harry, hidden talent?
Impressions.
Oh, go on then. Who can you do an impression of?
No swearing.
Yeah, that's the tough one. Conor McGregor?
Yeah, go on then.
I just don't mind being here on this interview. It's lovely to meet yourself. It's lovely to be sat here in London town. I must tell you, I'm sweating buckets over here.
I've got to say, you have got a hidden talent because that was pretty good, wasn't it? Like it. Harry, most used... No, that's wrong. Patrick, even. Last text you sent.
I'm going to check again. Uh-oh. I think it's my mum.
Come on, be honest. Oh, is it your mum?
That was my last text sent.
Yeah, I got some compedes. It's better-ish because I got a big blister on my foot. She was asking how it was.
That's a great answer. I like that. Harry, your most used emoji?
Probably the white heart. I'm quite really? Soft. He's always telling me off for putting text, kiss at the end of text. I'm quite soft with all my emojis.
Oh, no, I think it's nice. It's warm, isn't it? We like that. Absolutely. And Patrick, one thing about you that surprises people?
That I play hockey. I think that's...
do you?
Yeah, I played hockey all my life. I think that's a bit of a rogue one.
That we did not know that about you. I used to play hockey, but I was rubbish. And I used to make you wear the shin pads and stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it's one of them. Like, you either wear the shin pads or you play it at school and people just run around and smack you in the legs. So.
Little fun fact there about Patrick. Well, thank you, guys. You have passed. I'm loving that impression, by the way. 10 out of 10. And Patrick, let's go into your song choice. Shed 7 from the 90s.
I actually was on the train this morning and... You put on YouTube Chasing Rainbows and I saw like a live version of it from like 2018 at Transmit in Glasgow, and everyone was just there in the crowd like singing along, arms around each other, and just made me all emotional because that's been so long since anything like that's happened. Yeah. And, you know, we're getting back to like festivals coming back and you know, gigs and live music. So I thought I'd just you know, like sharing that.
Yeah, we like that. We're gonna check out the video right now.
There's things that I regret.
Harry and Patrick, this has been great fun. Thank you so much. Now remind us of everything we need to know and how we can follow you.
So hopefully by the time this is out, so will our first single, Let You Go. So you can head over to all of our socials. It's Since September Band on most things, otherwise Since September. So go check out the new single, hopefully. If it's not out by now, it'll be out in a few days.
Yeah.
So yeah, just go out and check all that. And then obviously there's tickets still left for the Little Mix Tour next year.
Yes. We're going to put details on the screen of how everyone can get tickets, including myself. Cannot wait for that. Now, we will be talking to the other guys on the other side of this. But thank you so much. I know it's been hot today, but we've been professional. We've made it through, haven't we?
Killed it.
Yeah, just about.
Just about. I'm dying right now.
Oh, bless you. Thank you so much. No, it's Harry and
thank
Patrick from Since September, everyone.
Thank you.
Guys, it's great to have you on the show. How are you?
Hello. Thank you. How are you?
Yes, I'm very good. And it's lovely to have you here, especially as we've been really looking forward to this show. And I want to get straight into Matthew talking about what happened, the process from going to the audition to the show. Give us all the goss.
Well, wow, it was all a whirlwind, let me tell you. It just happened so fast.
Was it?
It was a great experience. I compare it to summer camp quite regularly. It was the best summer camp I've ever been to. It was amazing. It was it was a dream come true. You see stuff like that on the television growing up, you know, those kind of shows. And to be on the other side of the television was definitely an interesting one.
Yeah, I bet. And Jacob, I know you sort of come from a musical theatre background, haven't you? So you had a little bit of training before in kind of that area, right?
Yeah. I actually just got my degree back the other day. I got a first in my degree.
Yay!
I did musical theatre degree. Musical theatre degree. So I was used to the performing aspect of it, but, you know, nothing can really prepare you for that. It was quite different, you know, using the in-ears and... it's actually a lot harder. People think it's harder to like play a character and stuff, but it's harder to be yourself actually.
Oh, really? Do you think so? Yeah. I've always wondered that because I've always really admired people that can get up on stage and just perform in these shows. But you're right. I guess being yourself is the hardest thing.
Yeah. Oh, no, it definitely is because you have to, there's no scripts to hide behind. You just have to, everything you say, it's taken at face value and it's you. So, yes. But yeah. it's good.
And have you been in any shows at all? What's your dream show to be in?
Oh, my dream show. Go on, Matt. See if you can guess what it is.
His dream show is The Phantom of the Opera.
It is The Phantom of the Opera.
Oh, yeah. It's a favourite. Yeah.
You wouldn't expect it, being in a band, being in a pop band, then going to play Phantom. But fingers crossed, one day.
My dream show, Hairspray.
Hairspray, seaweed.
Brilliant. We're going to go into you guys, your cover of Don't Start Now. I am in love with your cover of this. It's so good. Jacob, how did this all come about? How do you kind of put a song, you know, the arrangement together?
I think this must have been about 5 months ago now or something. And because we're in lockdown, we could only do stuff over Zoom and stuff. Yeah. So we kind of got together on Zoom and worked it out who was doing what. And then we all recorded our part, sent it to Harry, I think. Or was it you? Did you do Don't Start Now? So Matthew or Harry, and they put it together and you know, edited all the parts, and we did all the harmonies ourselves and all that, and then it turned out quite well, I think.
Yeah, it's turned out more than all right. It's fantastic. We're going to play it right now on the show. You're going to love this. Enjoy.
Did a full 180, it was so crazy, thinking about the way don't show up, don't come out, don't start caring about me now. Walk away, you know how. Don't start caring about me now. Aren't you the guy who tried to hurt me with the word goodbye? Though it took some time to survive you, I'm better on the other side. Don't show up, don't come out.
Questions from some of our lovely viewers. Chloe would like to know a little bit more about your brand new single. Now, this is really exciting. Jacob, tell us more.
So our first single is called Let You Go. We've worked on it for a while now. We've actually, I think, like, was it you and Harry started writing it like the beginning of the first lockdown? So before we were even really officially a band. But we've worked hard on it, and we're not seeing it as like, this is our brand new big first single, we need to get this to number, you know, we're just doing it as it goes. We've got so much music prepared. Our genre has changed a bit from the show. We're less pop, more like, we're more an authentic band. And it really honours itself to that kind of genre and to that style.
Yeah, fantastic. And I guess you guys have had the time, haven't you, since the show and obviously, you know, lockdown. It's given you that time to kind of write new material, right?
Yeah, absolutely. And yeah, just especially to find our sound as a band. We've got four such different music styles, you know, in terms of what we like to listen to. And we finally found that middle ground between the four of, oh, this has got a bit of everyone in it, and, you know, working out where to go with production and where to go with who sings what and stuff like that.
Yeah, fantastic stuff. And we cannot wait to check it out. We're going to put details on the screen below for everyone at home. Now, Matthew, Millie would like to know, what songs do you currently listen to?
What songs do I currently listen to? Millie, I listen to everything. Every single bit. I listen to rap. Yeah? I listen to many sad songs. You'll probably see me crying in my bedroom. A lot of songs. What songs? I currently listen to a song called Black Hole by... And that's called Griff on repeat, but the acoustic version. I don't want to hear that pop stuff. I want to cry. I want to cry, Millie. So put on Black Hole acoustic version.
Oh, well, I know another song choice of yours today is Justin Bieber, Peaches. Why this song?
Because I ain't crying to that. That's when I'm not crying. That's when I'm in the sun and I'm getting my peaches out in Georgia. Millie,
just to confirm, he's not going to cry.
No. You'll never catch me crying, but I couldn't be further away from tears when Peaches is on. You know what I mean? That's when you got me jiving. You got me dancing across the street.
Woo! Like it. Well, we're going to want everyone at home dancing out your seats right now. Enjoy this and we'll see you after.
I got my peaches out in Georgia. Oh, yeah. I get my weed from California.
Now, guys, we have got a little quiz for you about the whole of September. Are you ready?
We are.
Ready.
We are.
Okay, in this heat. Here we go. Matthew, which member of the band is always late?
Oh, who's me? Pat? I'm going to say Patrick. Pat. I'll say Patrick.
Yeah, it's a bit cool, actually. We can't even get Patrick in to defend himself right now, but no way. Yeah. No worries. Jacob, who's on their phone the most?
Probably this guy. In between everything that we've just done, he gets his phone out. There's always something to check. Yeah.
There's always, I'm a busy guy.
I can relate
guy.
To that.
I'm
it's just like guy. A comfort thing, isn't it? Yeah, you need no, to know that your phone's still well. There.
Yeah.
I'm with you on that. Matthew, who's the tidiest?
Jacob. Jacob's. Yeah. I was going to think of something funny, but Jacob's just too tidy.
Like it. Jacob, who has the worst handwriting?
Oh, I don't know. I don't think I've ever even seen the boys.
Probably you've never seen any of them? Okay,
Patrick.
Brilliant.
Yeah, probably.
We're going old school. Yeah. Yeah, all right, why not? Would you blame Patrick? Yeah. Matthew, who's the best cook?
Best cook, Harry. Harry's the best cook. That's my dad right there, yeah.
Ah, he did tell me, actually. Yeah, brilliant. Yeah, okay, right. Like that. Jacob, who's got the worst habit?
Pat, because he will... He will put something down and then kick it over as soon as he's put it down.
Pat, I've got something to tell you, mate. You're out.
You're out of the band. You're just too much of a mess.
Oh, bless
him. No, he knows it. He plays on it.
All right, then. Matthew, who's the funniest?
Me. Yeah. No bother. No.
Just like me.
No, there.
Like the confidence there, Matthew. Brilliant. Jacob, who's the most vain?
I think we're vain in different ways. I wouldn't be surprised if it's me, to be honest.
Right.
But I'll take one for the okay. team on that respect.
Mm. Oh, yeah, take one for the team, like it. And Matthew, who's the most attractive? I didn't write these.
Most attractive, wow, that's an interesting question. See, I believe that attractiveness is in the eye of the beholder. I believe personality comes first always in life. I feel that you can build a connection with someone from the inside out. But the stereotypical attractive definition, I would probably say, I'd say Harry.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, sorry. They no, like Jacob. That, Jacob.
Yeah, it's probably Pat.
Oh, Jacob.
I know. I think Harry is traditionally
the abstractive. Okay. Well, we won't show Harry this bit. We'll let him think he won that bit. And Jacob, who takes the longest to get ready?
Oh, I don't know. Actually, I think we're all pretty quick. You know, for four quite stylish boys, we're all quite quick. But probably Harry. Harry's got the most nail varnish to put on.
Mm.
Yes, I like his nail varnish. Okay, well, that's good to know. And Jacob, we're going to go with your song choice now. Paul Simon, You Can Call Me Out. Why this song?
Do you know what? I got on the train this morning, lovely weather, and I thought, yeah, You Can Call Me Out. Like, it's got that funky beat, and it's very feel-good. It's very feel-good.
Yeah, we like the feel-good on the show, so we are going to check out the video right now. Oh, Oh, guys, thank you so much. It's been so much fun having you on the show. And a big thank you to Roy from Scouting for Girls, who's your manager, isn't he?
He is. He is manager / best friend.
Oh, he's lovely, isn't he? He's so cool.
He's not too bad, that Roy. He's not too bad.
Well, hopefully he's watching, so we thought we'd give him a little shout out there. But thank you so much. We want to remind everyone to get tickets for the tour with Little Mix and also your new single, which is absolutely awesome. And again, we're going to put details on the screen below. But thank you so much. I hope it hasn't been too hot and you've just about survived.
No, anything for you, anything for you. It's been amazing. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
It's Matthew and Jacob from Since September, everyone. Woo! Huge thank you, Since September. Thank you to Harry and Patrick, Matthew and Jacob for being just wonderful on tonight's show. Now, I will see you same time, same place next week. We're going to leave you with One Direction, Drag Me Down, which is what Since September won the competition singing this. So enjoy this and we will see you then.
Never seen it look so easy. I got a river for a soul and baby, you're a bowl.